Mats, Madu, we are the children, we are the children of God. Come, 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 we change our world, we have what it takes to do it smart and make it smart. Welcome to our Smart Do.
Hello, class 4 pupils, how are you? I hope you are fine and I'm fine too. Welcome to today's lesson whereby we are going to look at fraction. In the previous lesson, we looked at fraction as part of a whole, whereby we said we can divide a whole. For example, we can divide a circular cutout into four equal parts. We are representing fractions as part of a whole. We fold it twice to form four equal parts. Then we shade one of the parts. We shade one of the parts to represent one over four of the whole piece of paper or the whole circular cutout. So today we are looking at fractions as part of a group. We can have a group of, for example, we can have a group of 10 pens or 7 pens. We can have a group of 7 pens whereby 4 of them are red and 4 of them are black and 3 are red. So we can have that those 7 pens here. We can have those 7 pens there whereby 3 of the of them are, no, let's have a 9 pens whereby 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 pens whereby 6 of them are black and 3 are red. So we can have the pens there. 3 red pens and 6 black pens. So we are representing fractions as part of our group. We can divide these pens into 3 groups, whereby we have one group to consist of the red pens, then the black pens, we divide them into 2 groups. So we have one group here, another group here, another group there. So in this case, we'll say that the red pens, so these are the red pens, then we have the black pens in 3 groups, just as they are. We have placed them here. So the red pens, the group representing the red pens, we have 3 groups, whereby one group will represent the red pens. So we can say the group consisting of the red pens is 1/3 of the 3 groups. So there are 9 pens. We've grouped the pens into 3 groups because we have 3 red pens which are here, then 6 black pens which are here. So these are the black pens, these are the red pens. So the group representing the red pens is 1/3 of the 3 groups. The group representing the black pens, the group representing the black pens is 2/3. So that is how we represent fractions as a group. That is how we represent. If we want to represent as the total, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we can say there are 9 pens. And of the 9 pens, 3 of them over 9 are red. Then 6 over 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 over 9 are black. Which is, when we place it as a group, we'll have 3 groups. One group consisting of 3 pens, red pens. Another group consisting of 3 black pens. Then 3 black, another group of 3 black pens. So the groups of the black pens are 2. There are 2 groups of black pens and 1 group of red pens. That is why we say one of the groups is red and 2 of the groups are black. We can still have other tins. We can have these tins here. Here I have 3 red tins. I'll call them red tins. Then I get other 3 blue tins. I get other three blue teams. So in total, I have six teams. I have three blue teams and three red teams. So in my explanation, we will say that we have two groups. We have one group with three blue teams, and another group with three red teams. These are blue, these are red. So there are two groups. So one of the groups, if I group them, one of the groups will have blue teams, while the other group will have red teams. So since there are two groups, I want to group them to show fraction as part of group. So one of the two groups will have blue teams, while one of the two groups will have red teams. So this group is 1/2 of the two groups. Because there are two groups, so we have one group with the red teams, the other group with blue teams. That is how we represent fractions as part of a group. For example, we can have a class with 12 pupils, whereby six of them three of them are boys and the rest are girls. So we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I'm assuming these are pupils who are standing in a line. So this, out of these pupils, four of them are boys. So I assume I've the shaded part shows the boys. So four of them are boys. If there are four boys and there are 12 pupils, how many boys are in that class? So what fraction will represent the boys? The fraction will represent the boys will be 4/12. 4/12 of the whole group of pupils. So how many girls are there? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 girls. So the fraction representing girls will be 8/12. If we want to place them in groups of 4, we'll have how many groups? 1, 2, 3, 4. We have another group here. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. We have another group here. So there are three. I now have three groups. So that means the group consisting of the boys is only one of the three groups. Only one of the three groups. How many groups are remaining? 1, 2. So 2/3 of the other groups will represent girls. So that is how we express fractions as part of a group. Thank you.